and Brad, the two most famous physical therapists on the internet.
Howdy, folks. I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
Together, we're the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
In our opinion, of course,
Bob. You weren't sure there for a second,
Brad? Well, I'm never sure.
Okay, how to fix your messed up sleeping position. Plus, we're doing a mattress giveaway. Let's jump right into that.
They fit right in.
If you're new to our channel, please take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on Stay Healthy, Fit, Pain-Free, and we upload every day. Also, go to bobandbrad.com. Go to the giveaway section.
Giveaway.
As we said, this week we're giving away a Sleepovation mattress. 700 tiny mattresses in one.
Outstanding.
Yeah, and this is just a sample of one, by the way.
Yeah, they have a whole cover and everything.
Yeah, and it's bigger.
Yeah.
you can also find it. It'll be pinned at the top of the page at Facebook. So that's why you want to like us on Facebook. You can go to Twitter, Instagram, or TikTok if you want a 60-second version of our program where we don't ramble.
And we have podcasts that are getting better and better every day. I didn't think they could get better from the first interview.
Great interview.
Except for that time that we were talking about your life or whatever. Just kidding.
All right. Do we want to say anything about the mattress? Very comfortable. Yeah. If you got pain, this is your mattress.
We speak from personal experience.
That's right. Brad, you're going to take it away? By the way, they do have a pillow too. If you want to sample a Sleepovation product, try their pillow.
Oh, yes. Yeah, they also have springs in them too. It's amazing.
Yeah, I think we had
You'd never know it unless you took it apart.
All right, let's get started, Brad. Number one. Yeah, we got 15 things to go over here, so let's get to it.
Messed up sleeping positions. Yeah. I kind of like, because you feel messed up when you're in bed and things are not feeling well, it hurts.
Number one, if you're lying in bed too long, like for instance, if you watch TV in bed and then go to sleep, your discs, the cushions between your bones, they actually fill up with fluid.
And that's normal.
And that's normal, but if you do it for a long period of time, it can start to cause your body to ache a little bit.
Sure.
That's why they surmise that when you have a flu or some illness and your spine gets achy, you always thought it was because of a fever.
Sure.
But it can be because you're getting too much fluid because you're lying in bed for way
12-15 hours or whatever.
Exactly. So until you get the fluid compressed out again, which is when you stand up and walk and stuff, it's going to be a problem. And astronauts, by the way, have this problem.
Oh, yeah. No gravity. There's a lot of studies that they've been working on with that.
Yeah,
we should do a video on that.
Their bones get weak, too. Yep. So, number two. So this goes along with number one. You're not walking upon waking. Because when you wake up, you don't want to do anything with your back because it's vulnerable because of the extra fluid in the back.
Right.
So you want to walk, and it helps compress those discs back down.
Right. Yeah, you're not going to get up and start, lifting weights, in the first 5 minutes.
Right, right. That's not a wise thing to do. All right, number three, you're watching TV in bed with too many pillows.
Oh, my goodness.
I'll throw a bunch of pillows here.
I did this once, and holy cow,
you paid the price.
A week.
You paid the piper.
Yeah, I always learn the hard way.
So Brad was on his couch, I believe, right?
Yeah, I thought I was, whatever. It was a pretty good movie.
My wife does this too sometimes. Yeah. I'm like, I tried to get her to stop.
Shake your finger at her.
But, your head is just flexed forward here. Yeah. Really an uncomfortable position over a period of time.
Here's his spine and here's his neck. We need to line him up and get it in that neutral position.
So the alternative to this is to actually use the wedge.
Yes. And so this isn't a wedge. We're talking about the one that looks like a triangle.
Yes. And so you lie this down.
There.
Lay this down. This would be laid down.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now you can use a pillow with this.
Oh, absolutely.
And see, I'm still lined up pretty well here. And I a little bit of flexion of the neck, but I can see the TV and even there's no TV there. So it makes me wonder about me. How do I see TV?
And these wedges are also made for people who have like COPD, have difficulty with breathing.
Regurgitation.
Oh.
GERD?
Yeah,
GERD.
GERD,
yeah.
What is that? Gastro reflux disease.
Esophagus.
Yeah, there you go.
Reflux disease, yeah. Gastro. I don't have it, so I don't know how to say it. All right.
We just call it GERD.
Next one, sleeping on the stomach. The reason this is bad for most people is because when you sleep on your stomach, if you want to give me one pillow, Brad.
Yeah. Well, you want the blue one?
Sure. Now, what you're doing, your head is turned all the way in one direction. Yep. And joints don't like to be at end range for a long period of time.
And you got 14 little joints in your neck right there.
Yeah. So you want to be in neutral sometime. I don't mind if you sleep on your stomach for a short period of time. But if you're going to sleep for a long time, you might actually put a pillow under here like this.
Oh, sure.
And then you can even kind of sleep like this.
Yeah.
So your neck isn't turned then.
Yeah. You put a little pillow there.
Put a little pillow there. Yeah. Yep.
Or just see if you can learn to avoid that.
And you'll wake up with an indent in your forehead from the fist on your head. But
especially if you like you had a ring, like a big diamond ring, and you were asleep on it.
Right.
Nice little dent right there. Maybe if the diamond fell out, it would stay in your
Could
forehead.
Your school symbol.
My mom just lost her diamond on her.
Oh, did she really?
Yeah. We can't find it.
Oh,
it's unfortunate.
Boy.
Yeah. Anyways.
Number six, it's kind of what I just showed you. If you sleep on your back with too many pillows, it also rounds your back,
sure.
Not just your neck.
Right.
So it's good. It's poor for your back, too. Sleeping on your side with the wrong number of pillows. So I'm going to show this. Generally on your side, you're going to have almost two pillows for most people because you got to fill in this gap between the bed and your head. And if you, I got my mic here, but if you have one, your head's going to be like this.
Mm-hmm.
And for most people, it's going to take two. And you have to experiment with that as far as the thickness of the pillow and what's comfortable.
You know, sometimes you can just fold it in half and you only have to deal with one pillow instead of two. And
what you see, a lot of people put their arm up there too,
sure.
Which is preference not to do that.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't want to have your arm like that all night long.
Right, because that can be a little circulation problem there. Are you going to lay down again? Can I sit?
Probably. I'm going to lie down again. Now you're sleeping on your side without a pillow between your knees. When you're on your side like this, a lot of people first go like this, and this is stretching the hip all night long.
Especially if your leg is hanging off the edge
of your
head.
Right, right. But even like this, it's putting a little bit of rotation on your back and putting a little stress on the hip. So you take a pillow, and I do this every night, and I put it between my knees, and it's easier on the knees, easier on the hips, easier on the back.
It just feels good, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You might want to buy something if it gets too hot in the winter.
They make special pillows for between the legs that are
just
a little more convenient.
I got one that's kind of cool. So, I mean, it's cool.
You put ice in it or something?
No, but it just seems to be made up.
Better airflow and everything.
Yep. Mm-hmm. All right, number nine, sleep on the side without support for the hip. We talked about that already. When you sleep on your side and your hip goes over like that.
We just talked about that.
Yeah, I know.
Let's go
on. All right. Sleep on a sore shoulder without the pillow canal. So you're going to want to set up two pillows here. You can sleep on your side. So you don't want your head going like that. But you use a throw pillow to create the canal.
Yep.
And so my sore shoulder, if you're insistent upon sleeping on the sore shoulder, you're going to sleep on here. But you're taking a lot of stress off the shoulder. Because you have pressure here instead of pressure here.
Right.
Yep. So it helps alleviate it. And it works really well. I think we've gotten good comments on that. And if you're going to sleep on your side with a sore shoulder on top, then you should be on your side like this. You want to grab that pillow.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't have that one there.
You might not. Right.
I suppose you could.
You could.
So the other shoulder doesn't get sore. But this is, my wife's got a sore shoulder and she sleeps on it. So, she goes on the other side.
Sure.
And she really likes this method right here.
It actually is best if you take two pillows.
Sure.
You take one.
Yep.
And then you take another. Yep. If you only have one, you kind of rotate in like that.
Yeah, it falls
down. So it actually works a lot better to use two. So lots of pillows.
You just, go out and, see if you can buy them by the bulk or something.
That's
right. So you get a little better price.
All right. For some people, especially if they have like a bigger buttock.
Yes. Buttocks.
We're not judging by any means. But if they have a larger buttock, they may actually have a large gap here when they lie on their back. And the back may actually round out a little bit and put pressure on it. So what we want you to try is first try a rolled sheet.
Sometimes especially if you have a poor mattress that's hollowed out, right, then it makes it even worse. Then this will be more helpful. But
it's going to show you how to put it on.
Roll it up like this. We got some tape so it doesn't come unrolled. And you can wrap it around twice. And then you take a, what do you call those, safety pins or, you know, something to secure it. And then that will get in this hollow spot here in your lumbar spine, and it'll help support that, and it'll feel much better.
Yeah, I mean, for someone that, like, if you have a really large buck, you're muscular.
Or you just have a hyperlordosis in your back, possibly.
Yeah, it's going to feel good. If you're one of those people that, like, I can't sleep on my back because it hurts, try this. Yeah. And then if you
I got to be honest with you, Bob. I distinctly, my spondylolisthesis, when we got the Sleep Ovation bed, that is the very first thing I noticed when I laid on my
bed. You sleep on your back.
I feel much better. I think, Mike, you've said the same thing. Our camera person and IT, he's pretty much our genius.
Yeah. So the thing is that with the Sleep Ovation, the individual mattresses actually, they support the low back no matter what position you're in.
Any of those hollow spots, yeah, it'll get right up.
Fill in the gap. So that's a little
Are you going to show the sleep
pillow? Yeah. So if you find the sheet works and you want to get something a little more permanent, what's it called? A sleep roll?
Yeah. Mackenzie sleep roll.
Mackenzie sleep roll.
Make sure
roll.
You get the right length because that matters. This one's a little short for Bob.
Yeah. It works.
Yeah.
So you can, you know, the same thing. I sleep on my back. It really fills in that gap. I sleep on my side. Yeah. It fills in the gap there too.
That's why I want to make sure you get a big enough one so it fills the side in when you roll.
And that's why Brad put the sheet around him twice there. So, all right. If you're going to sleep on your back and you have
spondylolisthesis
or spinal stenosis, you might try pillows under your leg, or you might try, this actually works much, much better.
Yeah, the sleep wedge. Yeah, there's a lot of people that benefit.
So
from
this is a sleep wedge, and the other one was the leg wedge, correct?
This is a sleep wedge. This is the leg wedge. That's the sleep wedge.
Right.
Leg wedge.
Oh, yeah. I screwed up.
Yeah, that's all right. It happens.
All right. So this slides all the way up, and we don't understand why, but it feels really good.
Yeah, the contact on the hamstrings. Because I have to admit, can you lift your legs up once? I've put one. Well, I usually use two. I actually use some throw pillows of mine on the couch, and that's all I have. And that's better. It helps. But this is even better
much
yet.
Better yet.
But you don't have to go out and buy one. You try this.
Try the pillows
first.
Yeah.
If the pillows feel good, this will probably feel even better.
Yeah, usually.
You know, put on your birthday or Christmas list.
Right.
There you go.
Well, they aren't too much. About 25.
Well, you don't want your family and friends spending lots of money.
Yeah,
give
that's
them
right.
Cheap,
there we
cheap
go.
Cheap gift and it make you feel good.
They're happy to get you something. All right. Let's see. We did that. Oh, the final thing, Brad.
Yeah.
Get a good mattress. So, you know, if you're firm, if you have a slender build, you can actually get by with a firm mattress.
Sure.
That's why they feel like a lot of the Asians, they sleep on those. What do they call them? They sleep on the floor.
Well, yeah. Those, Mike. What do you call those beds?
I don't know.
Futons.
There we go. And they're very firm.
Yeah.
So because they don't have, again, if you're bigger and curvier, you want a medium firmness.
Yeah.
And that's what the Sleep Ovation is.
I don't know if I slept on a futon once, and I would say, especially 25, 30 years ago, I was pretty thin, and it was a traditional
still
one.
Still bad.
It was still, I was like, I'm not sleeping on something this hard. But it was very traditional. They said it was traditional, very. But they're tough.
It's weird on the Sleep Ovation because it's they call it medium firm.
Yeah.
But you don't sink in, you know, as far as like rounding out your back.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It supports everything, but yet it's weird, isn't it?
It's good. It's
weird.
It
good.
Does what it's supposed to do.
So that's why you better sign up for the contest.
Well, it's nice. I think it has a lot to do with it. It has the 2 inches of the foam. It's not memory foam. It's some kind of patented foam. But then underneath that, it has the coiled springs.
Right.
So it's a combination of the two, which I've never seen it.
I've never seen
a lot
before
of
either.
I've slept on one of those memory foam ones, solid memory foam. And I didn't like as much because it takes a little while for you to sink in.
And then when you sink in, if you switch
roll,
positions,
there's a time element of it to sink
it
in again. And,
yeah.
And you know, this does not have that at all. But anyways, Bob, we're running late. We got to get out of here.
Ciao.